Meet Tier. Tier is a mobile application developer for the Acme Corporation, who are having a conference with lots of people attending. So she's built a mobile application to scan their details, and she needs to get the data into their CRM system and also notify people via the corporate messaging system that there's a new lead. So her application scans the lead, and she uses IBM Cloud Pak for integration to expose an API for her application to call. She then uses smart connectors to update the CRM leads application and also send a message to the corporate messaging application to let everybody know new leads arrived. This is working well. However, Tia has a colleague called Ava, who's a business development person. She goes out and she gets leads from everywhere. She's really growing Acme's business. But of course, she updates the CRM lead system directly. She doesn't go through the API. So this means the corporate messaging system doesn't know about Ava's updates. So what's Tia do about this? Well, let's try this again. What Tia actually wants to do is detect the change in the CRM lead system using IBM Cloud Pak for integration, and then take that change and put it into the corporate messaging system so that everyone can see any updates, no matter where they've come from. She uses a smart connector to detect the change and another smart connector to make the update. So let's try that again. Ava updates the CRM system through its UI. The smart connector detects the change in IBM Cloud Pak for integration and then sends the message to the messaging system. Simple as that. So it doesn't matter if the update comes through Tia's mobile app or if the update comes directly from the CRM system, both of them send the same message to the same messaging system. It means that no matter which way it comes in or which system is updated, all the data gets where it needs to go in real time. So how do we do that with IBM Cloud Pak for integration? Well, Tia's already built her API flow for the mobile app, and we saw that in a previous video. Takes the leads data into Salesforce and sends it to Slack. So what Tia's now going to do is create an event-driven flow. And she's going to take the Salesforce connector, and instead of doing an update, she's going to detect an event. And she's going to detect an event called a new lead in Salesforce. And the smart connector knows how to do this. It connects to Salesforce and connects the new event. When there's a new lead created, what does she do? Well, she uses another smart connector and sends the message to Slack. It's very simple. The Slack smart connector knows about Slack. It knows to go to a channel. It goes to the leads channel, just as we did when we built the API. And then Tia just types in the text that she wants. And again, really quickly, goes in, no string concatenation or anything. It's just like filling in an Excel sheet. So Tia starts the flow. And it's now listening for events in Salesforce and updating Slack. Now Tia's built her event flow, she needs to test it. She could use her mobile app. Probably easier just to reuse her API flow that she built in Cloud Pak for integration. So she goes to the test button, and it'll auto-generate some test data for her. Remember, this API is going to be putting a new lead into Salesforce. She adjusts the test data, hits send, and it's created a lead in Salesforce. So because it's created a lead in Salesforce, we can see that her Slack messages come out from her API, and also the new one we've got here that shows it's detected an event. Whether we want to or not, well, we can adjust that later. But we can see the Slack has come from both sources, the API and the event. Now she needs to test it as if she's Ava. So she goes into the Salesforce UI and creates a new lead from there. So she's going to go in and add all the fields for a new lead. And then when she creates it, that's created a new lead in Salesforce. The smart connector from Cloud Pak for integration picks it up and puts it straight into Slack. So we know both paths are working, both the API and if Ava goes in and enters it manually. So that means the flows themselves are working. But remember, Tia has only deployed her API flow into test and production. She now needs to add her event flow in. So she's going to export the executable, the bar file. And now she's going to upload it into the Cloud Pak for integration runtime so that it can be accessed. So she's going to go into the dashboard and upload her bar file into the bar file store. And what this means is we can expose this as a URL and access it from anywhere we want in OpenShift. And she copies the bar file URL there. Now Tia already has her API flow running as an integration assembly. So we could create a new deployment, but let's go and update the old one. It's going to be a lot easier. So Tia goes into the integration assembly, and you can see here that she's got her declarative API, her declarative product, and her connection details to Salesforce. So she's going to add a new integration runtime flow. She renames it to the notify lead flow, and she simply takes that bar URL and adds it to her integration runtime. Now, what she also needs to do is define all the configuration details of how to connect to Salesforce and how to get to Slack. But they're already here, so she can just simply wire them up in the canvas in the integration assembly, and now her integration runtime has all the connectivity details into Slack and Salesforce that it needs, same as her API. So she simply hits update. And this updated runtime assembly is now being deployed onto OpenShift. So again, it's secure, it's scalable, and it's ready to go. So the assembly shows her all the different parts. It knows the differences, so it doesn't bother updating the API. It just updates her event flow. And you can see that all of those runtimes are there. So again, just to test that it's running, she goes in, creates a new flow as Ava, and tests that in this environment, it's still working. And there we go, in real time, she's got her new very good lead, and she's ready to go. So, as well as just having an API that updates the CRM leads and the corporate messaging app, Tiz used Cloud Pak for integration to make sure that no matter where leads come from, either manually entered or via her API, they go to a corporate messaging app. She's taken her original application, her API one, and added the event flow into it nice and easily, and Cloud Pak for integration, using the integration assembly and integration canvas, has reused her connection details and deployed the differences so that it updates the application nice and simple, and it's all ready to go. Well, Tia, no matter where the leads come from at Acme, everyone will know about them through the corporate messaging system. It's time for those people to go chase those leads up.